Holy shit. Holy shit, that was worse than having Freddy Krueger in my dreams. With yourself, the good doctor's got in your head, you're going to go back vegan, aren't you? You're willing to shit blood out your back passage? You're gonna do it, you're gonna do it! What are you talking about? Would you stop getting in my head? I'm not going back vegan. I do care about animals, but I'm not going back vegan. No, no! Well, they say you never really were vegan. You did it wrong. You were gaslighted, you're just an absolute shit cunt. What are you going to do about it? What are you going to do about it? Oh, you're telling me that gaslighting means people will tell you what's best for your health, your family and your future? That rings a bell to me. I'm not toxically masculine, just get out my head. I'm not toxically masculine, I'm not toxically masculine.
I don't want to be the big daddy with the spear.
What do you expect me to do? What do you expect me to do? Oh, that's what you want me to do? But then they'll say I didn't care about animals. Are you sure about that? Okay, I'll go away with the flow here, right? Let's do it. This is like some Invasion of the Body Snatcher stuff. I've even got a different shirt on here. Wait a minute. Are you trying to gaslight me? Are you trying to make me toxically masculine? Are you trying to make me like the big daddy with the spear, the big man? Is that what your game is? Listen, Tommy. At the end of the day, they say you're gaslighted. They say you're toxically masculine. They say you want to be the big daddy with the spear. And I'm just going to be honest with you, unlike all those guys who weren't in the first place, yeah, I'm trying to gaslight you, but I must admit, you're going to feel a lot better. You may as well prove them right. Guys, welcome back. Today we're going to do a little response to the good doctor, the mental health professional that is Michelle Lowe, a challenge to Tofu Tommy. So let's get into it. Let's see what she has to say, shall we?
This video, which was a series of clips, actually about 40 minutes worth of clips from an interview that lasted an hour and a half, something like that, over on Primal Edge Health's channel. Very shortly after that video went live, I received an email from Tristan. YouTube informs me that you've re-uploaded my video. I've got no issue with you taking clips and editing them. Weaving your funny delusional narrative and giving me a good laugh, but uploading half of my video on your channel is ridiculous. Please take this down. If you do not, I will file a copyright claim, not the type that will give you a strike, and YouTube will remove the video. So I wrote back saying, keep up the fantastic work, Tristan. So be it if YouTube removes the video. That's fine. I consider it fair use. So it's up to YouTube. As of 16:54 on Thursday, the 9th of July, that video is still live. So Presumably, if YouTube want to take it down, they absolutely can do. I joined BitChute, and here we are, here's the video.
There you go! She's on BitChute as well! She's everywhere! She's on all devices! A bit like Joey Cabstone! So guys, full disclosure here, what actually is up to speed at the moment. Actually, the video has been taken down. She obviously agreed to with Tristan to obviously remove the video, and he removed the copyright strike as well. But still over in BitChute, there was a lot of comments on there. I'll not go into it. Just the usual carry on, but that's where we're at the moment. Michelle obviously wants to come on and obviously do a debate with me eventually. Well, a debate, it was not a debate really. She said it's a friendly discussion. We'll see. I'll discuss that later.
Interview. The full video is 2 hours and 12 minutes. Like I said, the interview didn't last that long, maybe about an hour and a half, because actually what Tristan has for the first... 23 minutes of this video. This is his intro, and it's a whole series of clips from well-known vegans.
Well-known vegans.
This channel are on there. Very briefly, we've got Klaus from Plant Based News.
Klaus.
We've got Human
Soy Vegan, Boy.
Earthling Egg.
Earthling Vegan Egg.
Joey Carbstrong.
Joey looks like an egg.
Oh.
Big man with a spear, toxic masculine, the big daddy.
Vegan Gains, Garth Davis, a long series of clips from the interview that Vegan Gains had with John Venus.
Egget.
And then finally, me, about gaslighting before...
Gaslighting! Gaslighting! You're gaslighting ya! Of course you don't, Michelle. You're always on the channels. Frankie Boys channel.
Vegans taking over the world and vegan agenda and conspiracies, and it was nothing related to Tofu Tommy that I could see. But shortly, I am going to play you the whole of that 22 minutes. And if Tristan wants to argue the toss that he puts together, and therefore they're his, well, he can argue the toss, because, frankly, he's just a triggered little snowflake.
Oh, it's triggered! Triggered!
Tommy Kelly, ex-Tofu Tommy, I'm going to issue him a challenge. Stay tuned for that.
Oh, dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Here it comes. Fighting out of the red corner, there's Michelle Lowe, weighing X amount of pounds. In the blue corner, there's Tommy Kelly. Ex-vegan, vegan wars, Battlefront, Revenge of Michelle Lowe. Of course you don't.
Well, you know, it's all very positive. You know, you don't see very many vegans in here, do you? Now, is that because they don't watch the channel? Or is that because if they try to comment on the videos, they just get deleted? So... one reason for putting it on my channel is that at least vegans get to see it, and they also...
She's doing you a great service, guys.
About it.
Spreading the vegan message. The vegan online wacktivism.
Re-upload half of the video. It took me ages to...
Spilling the tea. The English tea. From Michelle and Charlie. Let's see what they have to say.
Tommy, glad to see you're doing well. Yeah, Tommy had a goofy face as a vegan.
True.
Masculine with a better jaw.
Oh, toxically masculine, don't say that.
Comical. I love your intro as always. I can't stop laughing my ass. I love the
audio. That is funny.
In this video, thanks for sharing your story. Let's talk about honesty just for a moment. Are you absolutely sure, Tommy, that everything you said in your video
Full disclosure here, I'm 100% sure everything I said in my video was 100% honest, because I lived it, I experienced it. And Michelle, I want to put out there, I've actually emailed you constantly telling you to stop the slander, trying to say that I relapsed from an eating disorder, which I didn't do. My wife has actually told you this, my family's told you this in comment sections, yet still you perpetuate this nonsense, and you're a mental health professional, as you call yourself, a psychologist. Absolutely nonsense. I never relapsed with an eating disorder. I was doing absolutely great. My health declined massively from veganism in the last year and a half. Like I already explained in my previous videos, I was having brain fog. I was having short-term memory loss. So bad that my wife was actually asking me questions or telling me something, and I would totally forget what she said within 30 to a minutes, 30 seconds to a minute. It was absolutely shocking. I was suffering mouth ulcers, passing blood, going to the toilet up to 16 times a day. Plant fibre just seemed to absolutely destroy me. And it's that bad, I've got to watch what I'm doing now, because any time I revert back to like a few days of plant foods, the problems are at the surface. Like I say, I'm absolutely doing fantastic. I obviously add in some vegetables. I can add in portions of vegetables, but there's a certain wall, or should I say a certain ceiling that I hit, where things just become an absolute issue because of everything that I've been through with veganism. I was actually suffering the drooping the left side of my face. My wife actually thought I had a stroke because I was muttering words. I didn't know what I was actually saying, and I was wondering how she couldn't make out what I was actually saying to her. It was absolutely shocking. Anxiety, depression, taking it out on my wife, just for silly things, just losing the place when she said something. Why are you saying this? No, you know what I mean? Just being very, very ratty. It was absolutely shocking, guys. The big, big change obviously happened when obviously my professionals actually said to me, look, we're giving you the option, but at the end of the day, it's down to you. And this is what I want to put out there. What actually happened was, if I continued to get more unhealthy and my health declined even more and more and more, I would end up having to go to a medical ward. That's what they actually said to me. But they says, at the end of the day, this decision is yours. We're not going to force you, but we're going to tell you what we advise, and then obviously your health and your future's in your own hands. So I said, okay, I obviously don't want to end up in hospital. I'm going to go ahead and do what they tell me. So I went ahead and done what they told me, believing that it probably wouldn't work. And I actually thought, well, at the end of the day, I think it's just all my own fault. I don't feel this is going to work. And I thought I would be back to veganism in no time. And that was my full intentions, because I actually care about animals and I care about people. And that's what I want to put out there. It's not an exclusive thing to care about animals when you're not vegan. Like, people seem to think that vegans is an exclusive club. Like I say, we're all against factory farms, and that's what we want to be looking at. We want to be looking at to obviously eradicate things like that, give animals the best life possible. And I know you'll probably say, well, that's not possible because an animal's getting slaughtered for your meat production. But at the end of the day, it's the sad reality of the world we live in, guys. This is what it is. We're living a fallen world, and I've talked about this constantly. If you obviously are a Christian, or if you're not a Christian, the way I look at it, my morals have always been based on Christianity all my life, and that's always going to be that case. And I believe that we're living in a fallen world, and at the end of the day, life consumes life, and that's the sad reality of it. So if your health fails, you've just got to do your best within your health and your morals as well. And obviously, they'll obviously put out this nonsense that you're just an anecdote, you don't matter. But at the end of the day, guys, let's look at it a different perspective. If you go to a doctor or any surgeon or a nurse or anything, the only thing they care about is your anecdote. That is the most important thing to you, because it doesn't matter whether any diet works out in the real world or if what science says. At the end of the day, if it doesn't replicate for you, it doesn't matter. And that's what I put out there. To be vegan, you've obviously got to follow a plant-based diet. In my opinion, there's a lot of things devoid in the vegan diet, and I'm not saying it doesn't work for everybody. Like I say, if it works for you, keep doing it. But I would say, if you're having struggles and you're having issues, think about it, really, really examine it, and ask yourself, is this the diet that's doing this to me? Am I doing the best for me? So on we go with the video.
Eating disorder story. I've listened to the videos on your channel when you were vegan. I used to follow you. I have a lot of sympathy for you. Right, you can eat what you want or you can not eat anything. To me, doesn't matter. Much rather you'd be vegan, but if you don't want to be vegan anymore, then whatever, make up any excuse or any reason why, it's up to you.
See, this is what she's doing here. She says you can eat what you like or you can eat nothing. So she's planting the seed but not actually saying outright this is what she does. She's in comment section slandering me, saying that I've relapsed from an eating disorder. When obviously as well, I've been 100% open about my whole journey. I've obviously told you in the past that I relapsed. Sorry, pardon the juice there. Obviously told you that I relapsed with the loss of my dad and obviously my wife's situation with obviously an ovarian cancer and the 4 miscarriages she had. I've never been anything open but honest, and I can tell you 100% I never relapsed, and look at me now. If you're saying that the eating disorder was a problem, why exactly am I doing so great now when I've been on my own for well over 10 months? No input at all, apart from obviously when I want a phone call with my therapist if I feel I need it. Like I usually phone her like every month just to keep me accountable, not for the case that I need it, just to keep them, keep myself accountable and keep myself on that track. I obviously help people with eating disorder recovery. I do coaching. I'm an eating disorder volunteer from the charity in the UK doing online support and things like that. I do a lot of mental health advocacy for that prime reason, that I'm in the best place that I've ever been. My health is absolutely amazing, guys. I'm currently eating 3,200 calories. Before, as vegan, I was eating 2,800, and I actually had meal support at home as well. And they obviously stayed with you, obviously, after you had the meal to make sure nothing happened. So just in case they throw in that thing there, saying this shit that I obviously went in the toilet and made myself sick. Absolutely bullshit, guys. Don't listen to the generic carry-on about eating disorders. Eating disorders are very multifaceted. And for me, it was grief. It was never about body image and obviously the food as well, because it's just a coping mechanism. So on with the video again.
Vegan activists you mentioned and the movements you mentioned, are you sure that everything you said was honest? Can you actually stand by everything you said in that video, in that interview? That's just an open question.
See, what she's trying to do here, she obviously talks about people gaslighting you. So she'll say things like, people will gaslight you, they'll tell you it's best for your health, they'll tell you it's best for your family, they'll tell you it's best for your future. But that is the actual vegan code. That's how they conduct themselves, they gaslight people. She's trying here to discredit me. Why should I have to defend my position and basically to prove that I'm innocent? Just for you, I could say anything about you, Michelle, and you would have to defend your position, but I wouldn't do that, because I believe you're actually a good person down at your heart, but at the same time, you seem to discredit people. You obviously do these things for views, which I understand, that's YouTube, but at the end of the day, this is absolutely shocking, because everything I said, I stand by 100%. Veganism and the actual activism movement itself is absolutely toxic. There's bullying, there's obviously things where everybody wants power. It's all about them, it's all about being basically bearing witness to yourself. You've actually had comments in your own video from one of my dear friends who actually told you that, or October Rain Rocks. This is actually in this video as well. I think, if I can actually find it here, guys, I'll actually show you, just to let you know exactly what's going on here. Here it is, here. There you go. Hi guys, I just wanted to pop over here to say that I'm a good friend of Tommy and would like to take a moment, if I may, to say that due to that, I won't be commenting in detail on the original post's video content, other than to say that I agree with everything he said regarding the activism points he raised and the majority of the points he raised regarding that side of the vegan community. What I will be commenting on, however, is another aspect of it though. Don't get me wrong, there are a lot of decent people within the community too. However, sadly, way too many people are as Tommy mentioned, unfortunately. I also know so many others within the community that would agree with that point as well. In fact, it's pretty common knowledge these days, which is sad but true. I understand a lot of people will disagree with him, And not because they think he is right or wrong, but probably and mainly due to the fact he is no longer vegan, which I find the most concerning thing about the community at times, in that they will disown an individual based on the fact alone sometimes. I have also witnessed individuals that have known him for years, some even calling him a good friend, turning on him for those exact reasons and telling him as much, which I find pretty unbelievable. I don't turn my back on friends and never would, simply because they chose another path. Don't get me wrong, everyone has the right to their own opinion, but not at the expense of another human being's feelings. Many vegans talk about speciesism, meaning a belief of humans that all other species of animals are inferior and may therefore be used for human benefit without regard to the suffering inflicted. So I find it rather strange how we are seeking to eradicate speciesism and are trying to stand up for all the animals, yet we're still completely disregarding the Human Rights Act, which does indeed highlight some of the following legislations within it. For example, the right to life, freedom from torture and inhumane, degrading treatment, freedom from slavery and torture, and the right to liberty and security. Human rights are the basic rights and the freedoms that belong to every person in the world from birth until death. They apply regardless of where you're from, what you believe, or how you choose to live your life. So therefore, shouldn't Tommy be able to live his life? Based on how he chooses to move forward with that life, owning his own thoughts, beliefs, and following, therefore, his own moral compass. It also doesn't mean that everyone has to agree with his choice. It simply means he has made one that he is personally comfortable with. Has his new journey changed my mind regarding my own journey? No, I'm just as comfortable on the path I am. I will always be vegan, and I say this with as much passion and vigour as I hold for my own beliefs. I will never speak ill of another friend's because they are choosing to speak their own truths, follow their own paths and personal journeys. There's enough hatred and judgment in this world without adding to it. With regards to the channel Tommy has chosen to discuss the topics in the original video, I cannot comment on it personally as I know nothing about him on the channel in question and very little vegan YouTube channels anymore because I find a lot of them pretty negative and difficult to watch. I do, however, watch a lot of channels that are recipes and share topics approached in a slightly different manner. I appreciate your channel because you give people a chance and are usually fair, unlike a lot of other channels. So she obviously goes on to obviously discuss a lot of things, like I say, talking about her, obviously, just like exactly what I told you. Obviously, you've got Hench Herbivore coming away with the nonsense here, saying that I messaged him, asking his perspective on why I failed. Veganism, why I failed! And he's saying here, when I told him it was due to his eating disorder, he told me he had never had an eating disorder. I won't speak to him again. I don't enjoy obvious, massive, bare-faced lies. Here's another load of crock shit from the actual idiot that sells ebooks to people and just is all about the money. What's his tagline? Give us your money! That's exactly what he's about. So what actually happened was, guys, I never private messaged them. Why would I private message them? I actually commented on one of his videos, and what I actually said was, it was a video about John Venus, and I actually commented telling my story and obviously why I actually, the health issues that I actually had and why I'm actually the best I've ever been at the moment. He commented back saying everything was about my eating disorder. I commented saying it wasn't my eating disorder, so I don't know why you're saying that. And yet he's trying to make out that I said I never ever had an eating disorder in the past, and I private messaged him. Who's the barefaced liar? But yeah, never responded back, as you can well see. So what can I say about that? I think my reply is actually there, if I can actually find it. View 29 replies. This is my wife actually commenting. So I don't know where my comments went, actually, guys. That's pretty strange, but you'll actually find it on the video anyway. But yeah, that's what I said anyway, but let's see what else Michelle has to say about it, shall we? Wow.
So, this is my comment section, so let's just take a quick look through.
Let's check Michelle's comment section.
Enjoying the little,
that she incited hate in. Yeah, makes herself out to be the good doctor.
Playing in
the psychologist. Psychoanalyzing you.
The 22, minutes or whatever it was from Tristan's intro. And if you want to hear the sound and you want to see exactly what clips Tristan played, then of course go over to Tristan's channel. You know, he's a great friend of this channel.
So oh, he is. He's actually gave you plenty of shout outs, Michelle. Actually, he's probably grown your channel more than you have. So,
so let's take a look at some of these comments. Tommy has no idea he's being played, laughed at, and used. Tristan looks bored. He's not even listening to Tommy. I've made that point before about Tristan.
Ooh.
He doesn't appear to listen. Even some of the non-vegans that follow me are arguing against. In the interest of balance, I say I have to wanted to yell, shut up at Tristan. And he was low-grade bullying Tommy. And Tommy just did not realise.
Absolutely nonsense, guys. See this crap trying to say that he's gaslighting me, that he's bullying me, he wasn't listening. Actually, Tristan's helped massively over the months, and I want to give him a big, big thanks for that, because the support that all yous guys have given me in this community and things like that, yous actually cared about my health, yous didn't care about what ideology I was actually following, yous just wanted to see me get better, as did Tristan. And I'm not saying that there's not bad people in all walks of life, because yeah, there is, but just because somebody isn't vegan, do you actually think that that makes them a bad person? No, it doesn't. Like I say, there's great, great friends that I've got that are vegans. There's great, great friends that I've got that are not vegans. And I want to put out there, and that's what I've always said. But the way you treat people in the vegan community, no wonder it's called a cult, because this is exact same behaviour that people do to people in cults when they actually have to leave. Disgusting.
Tristan, a typical pseudo-alpha male, taking the lead. People like this guy just want to be recognised and belong to something.
Oh. Yeah.
Tommy came into veganism.
I want to belong to life, which I wouldn't have had if I'd stayed.
An easy target for gaslighting by anti-vegans, that's it. And he said himself, you know, that Bobby's perspective and Drew Morgan befriended him. And I've said numerous times on this channel that those two are behind a lot of this gaslighting. That goes on.
Here we go again with it. Gaslighting ya. Oh, Jesus. Right, full disclosure here as well. These people reached out to me, not telling me what to do or anything like that. They actually reached out because they seen that I was actually struggling. They wanted to obviously see me get better. Did they ever gaslight me? At the end of the day, I could have just told them to, you know what I mean? We're not going to say that word, F off, on YouTube, but that's actually what I could have done. But I realised, well, what's people actually want here? Do they want to see me get better, or do they want to actually follow me just to have me as another label on their ex-vegan list? No. You can believe what you want, but that's far from the truth.
Within the vegan community behind the scenes on YouTube. I mean, one thing that, you know, Tommy did get right was in saying that, you know, the YouTube space is pretty toxic, and you do have to have your wits about you. Yeah. Anyway, my brain is melting following this BS. That's true. Abalaciel.
Oh, here we go.
Tofu Tommy led the world's most dishonest defamation campaign against my channel, and some of the stupidest people on earth lined up to be on his side. I don't remember that, actually. Maybe it was...
Here's another one from Abalaciel, Isomazad. Well, what actually happened there, guys? This is another from a barefaced liar as well. What actually happened was, a friend that I'm not going to name, actually, at the time, was in the vegan community. He actually was on YouNow, which was a streaming platform that you may have heard of. It was quite big back in 2016. He actually has high-level autism. He's a high level in the spectrum of autism. What he actually tried to do, because of a lot of bullying, he actually tried to stab himself on camera, live on stream. And what actually happened was, I was one of the few people that was actually in the stream comments at the time. I actually contacted the services along with another friend, and we got the services out to come to obviously help him, because we were worried that he was obviously going to take his life, which did look like. Isomazad actually made a video basically mocking him about, obviously, a vegan stabbed himself on camera, it was called. So a friend from Australia actually come up with the idea to obviously do a video in support of this guy, to obviously try and show him support that he actually needed, because at the end of the day, a guy like that, that was susceptible and obviously vulnerable to more bullying, was it the right thing to do to obviously make a video about him basically mocking him? So I decided to do a video along with it. I said, yes, I'll do a video. So it was me and another friend from Australia and then a friend from England that I won't mention as well. The three of us made a video. So we put that up and we gave him some support. He's trying to paint here out here that I started some hate campaign. Far from the truth. He actually bullied a guy and that's the actual truth.
Before but, I joined YouTube, I started watching vegan YouTube in like the summer of 2016. Early summer 2016, I'm not sure. Maybe I did follow that, I don't remember. Tristan is dangerous. He's a legend in his own lunchbox. That's
dangerous!
That is for sure.
He's got the big spear, he's dangerous. The big spear, the big daddy. So we're going to push on with this video because this is just all comments. Let's see what she has to go on to say at the point. Whoop, here we go.
See it, plan it, analyse it, track it, hedge it,
typical.
Short it. Me, or you can get me on any of my social media, and yeah, if you want to, if you're up for it. And again, I'll be very polite, I'll be very cordial, I'll make sure that the chat is also polite.
Oh, so you will, Michelle. So, full disclosure, I've emailed her, I've told her these things, I've told her to obviously stop slandering me in comment sections, which she still continues to do, even in a live stream about last week about vegan activism, she was still making out about relapsing my eating disorder, which I already told her days before not to do so. Like I say, doesn't stop that. Well, what's this going to achieve? Is it really going to achieve anything, me going on actually speaking to her? I don't think it actually is. Is it going to help any parties? No, because you've decided that I'm lying. So have the vegans. So, where are we going to go?
There you go. That's the challenge. And are you up for it, Tommy? Because if you can absolutely stand by everything you said, then why not? Why not do it? Guys, thank you for listening. And check out my Patreon if you want to support the channel in any small way. Check out my merch.
And I will speak to you tomorrow. Bye, guys. That sounds like some kind of mental institution. Sounds. Wow. So anyway, there we go. There's a challenge from Michelle to Tofu Tommy. To Tofu Tommy. And Tofu Tommy. Just remember that. I was thinking, what should we call ourselves now? Tenderloin Tommy? T-Bone Tommy? I don't know. yous give me the suggestions, guys. Anyway, what I actually wanted to say as well, Tristan says, absolutely not, I've not to do that at the stream with you, Michelle. He said that if I actually do it, he's going to give me 50 lashings. And obviously I reached out to Bobby's perspective, and Bobby's perspective on this, me going on to speak about you, was an absolute no. And Drew just goes like that, don't do it. See, if you do it, I'm going to kick your, that thing, you're behind. So yeah, that's where we're at. Anyway, guys, I hope yous liked this. Let me know anything else yous want to see on the channel. Hope yous have a great, great week. Catch you in the next video. Peace.